All right, doing a video here on gold. We had another positive week. There were a lot of swings in the price of gold. Lots of ups, lots of downs, really helping to drive opportunity over this past week. But even if you didn't get in on a dip, or if you're just watching and trying to just get an idea of where gold is going, hopefully this video will help you out a little bit. So we'll be looking at the gold futures. That's what's up on the screen right now, /GC. Then we'll be moving into GLD, which I feel like more people are trading and people are probably a little bit more familiar with. But GC, these gold futures, to me, they just have a nicer chart and it's easier to see some of these price levels. So let's go ahead and dive on in. I'm going to be looking here at the weekly chart because I think that gives us a good idea of where we're going to be moving in a long-term sense. You know, you can look at the 15-minute, the 1-minute for entries on gold or really just any stock, but you want to look at the longer time frames if you're wanting to buy this as more of a swing or even, you know, more of a you're just putting it into your portfolio. If you're going to be day trading it, you might not necessarily really care a whole lot about the long-term time frame. It's still important, in my opinion, but you might not look at it. But for me, let's look at it from a long-term time frame as something that you would want to hold in your portfolio or for, you know, just a few months, maybe a few weeks or something of that nature. So starting off, you know, we closed out the week around 1675, which we saw a nice little push. But where does that really put us in the grand scheme of things? Is that going to be a top? You know, if we were just looking at the screen like this, you might think, wow, you know, that's pretty high up there. The RSI is up there. The PPO is, looks like it's starting to round off. And yes, I do think that that is the case. I think that we are pretty extended, especially since this previous little flag. You can see these are really just kind of like flagging patterns that we have been seeing over the past year or so. So it could be that we are getting up near a top and we might start to see a decline. And maybe right down here around to the 1580 level. We actually saw us hit that level a couple times this week, but we could get to the point where we see that little bit of a flag before we see that next stage up. But let's go ahead and move it back out. So what I'm really looking at here are where are the key resistance levels as we move forward. And to me, we need to look at 2011 to 2013. And we can do this on the futures and GLD, but again, I like to look at the futures. So what I've marked here as the first support level, again, we're trading around 1675. And let me back this out. It's a little bit easier to see. Okay, there we go. That's a little bit better. I know we can't see where we're currently trading, but, you know, just hang in there with me. So our first support level, which we bounced off of a little bit this week, was right around that 1635 mark. And you can see that acted as a top. It also acted as a support for a few weeks back here in 2011, 2012, and even into 2013. And then we finally broke down. And you can also mark, but probably not as much as a resistance, is up here around $1,700. Usually those whole numbers, so you know, 1700, 1800, 1900 are going to be marked as supports and resistance levels, but then we can narrow them down. This one just so happens to be right around that $1,700 price point. We can actually even move it down a little bit, in my opinion, probably right in here around 1690. And as we move and look at the current chart as we sit, you'll see that that is pretty bang on. So 1690. And then after that, what we're really going to be looking is up here around 1782. So that is a pretty big jump. It's about a 5% jump. And we honestly might see that pretty quickly. You can see we only had a little bit of trading that kind of stopped out here, which we could say right around the 1750 mark. But we're just going to leave that. Don't want to get it too cluttered. But 1690, then we're looking up here around 1780, 1785. And then after that, we had this blow-off top here in 2011 that put us up here at 1900. So let's move it on back and look at where we are currently trading now. And you can see we topped this level a couple times right here at 1690. And where would our next spot be? Would be up here around 1785. And if we were to break through, again, we'd be up here closer to 1900. We'll call it 1880, 1890. And if we move into a more close time frame, right in here, we can see some of these levels holding true. So we had this nice momentum run up here all the way up to where? 1690. And then we broke down, we held right around where? 1635, 1640, then we broke back down and we are hitting 1580. It was honestly a very interesting week because we saw the price of gold was so volatile. It was swinging all over the place and we are hitting all of these key support and resistance levels all within the span of, you know, just a few days over the course of, you know, I think it was, you know, probably about 5, 6, 7 trading days that we are hitting all of these key support and resistance levels from a decade prior. So that's crazy that those levels are still holding true. But they, again, were very pivotal levels back in 2011, 2012, and 2013. And, you know, that's why it's good to look at those long-term time frames and see that, okay, where are we going to see the price of, you know, XYZ? It doesn't have to be gold. XYZ moving forward. Okay, we are trading at this price level 8 years ago. Those could be some good levels to look at as a support or resistance level for my trade moving forward. So, nonetheless, there we go. And as we move into next week, depending on what the overall market is doing, I think if we are still seeing more shakiness, more volatility in the market, we again are going to see these pretty big moves up in gold. I would not be surprised, even if the volatility subsides, I don't think gold is just going to retrace back all of these gains and move back down. I think it's going to hold pretty steady. And again, you know, once we break through this 1690 level, 1680 level, my next target would be around 1750 as a small resistance, and then the 1785 level here on the gold futures. Now I'm going to go ahead, in the sake of time, put up GLD on the screen. And again, this is going to be relatively the same chart. We'll look here at the 20-year, and we can see, okay, so we've got some resistance in here around, I was calling it the low 158s as far as my trading went, and then here would be our upper bound, which would be equivalent to the 1785 mark, would be for gold up here. Around the 172, the low 172s, to be conservative. We could put it at the top of the wicks, but I would prefer not to. We could honestly move it down even lower, to me, closer to 170, as these were more of like blow off tops. Like, we just had enough momentum to blow through 170 and then we pulled back down. We blew through 170 and pulled back down, through 170 and pulled back down. So we'll call 170 the mark, and then up here would be our top. Really, this one, I don't know, it'll probably just act, as we get up to that price point, it'll act as a resistance. We'll pull back probably slightly and then we'll push forward through it. But usually these momentum filled runs, where it's just the price is really just kind of out of control, it doesn't really hold a lot of value when it comes to a support or a resistance level. For that sake. So, and then here on GLD, looking at the closer time frame. So if we're looking here, you can see here these levels again. You know, we are hitting up here in the low to mid 158s. We pulled back down here to around the 150 mark, which was this support right in here around the low, or the 150-50 mark. 150-60 was right in there, and then we have swung back up. So, as I see GLD moving forward, let's go back to the weekly. I would like to see us somewhere up here in relation to that 1750 level of the gold futures. We'll be right in here around 164. So right in there, 164, 165. You can pull it down a little bit. And, you know, for gold, that would still be a nice little 4% gain here on GLD. With that upper level, which would be what I'm really looking at, would be around an 8 to 9% gain. So, you know, the choice is yours as to what it is that you want to trade or put into your portfolio, but just make sure that what it is that you're wanting to trade is in an upward trend, so you already have the momentum on your side. If you're trying to bottom pick or catch some falling knives, it can be really thrilling if you nail it. But if you get it wrong and, you know, maybe it only goes up a little bit and then it sinks even lower, you know, that can be a pretty crushing feeling. So trading with the trend to the upside is usually your best bet. Again, everything has a top, so just be mindful of what it is you're trading, what it is you're holding, and never really lose sight of, okay, I'm up 20% because it could dip pretty quickly. Nonetheless, I hope that you guys enjoyed the video, maybe got something out of it. If you want to leave a like or comment on how I can make these videos better, please let me know. So, thank you guys for watching.